Once upon a time, there lived a little girl with a broken heart. She was small for her age, and she was brave, and she was always eager to strike up a conversation with a stranger. Her best friends were the gold merchants in Jeddah, the old gypsies in Paris, the backpackers in Singapore. She captured attention in butterflies. She told her tale to anyone who would listen. She told of her much older brother who taught her to swear, of her slightly older sister who was her companion on her endless journeys around the world. She told of her dad who traveled a lot, but always brought her back treasures, and of her mom who was always there with her cup. And she told of her scar, always thinking about the outcomes of her ships. She received the first iteration of her scar when she was 5 days old. Her small body turned blue, and a swift diagnosis of congenital heart defect was made. When asked why she had this scar, the tiny girl, not having the words to articulate what she had survived, tells people that she was born with a broken heart. 8 years later, a new scar was made along the footprints of the old. The first inklings of her future psychosis manifesting themselves at the age of 12. She was diagnosed and medicated with the first of a series of chemicals intended to balance her mind. While this is the story of a little girl with a broken heart, just wanted to say this, it's also the story of her descent.
Until my body was laid out on a cold metal slab, dissection the only means to diagnose my mother.
watch the Grammys. This show skates by in a blur of color and music and really good post-operas. Until I die.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and bringing me out of dark.
She's returning to the music world after losing her voice. The first notes of Rolling in the Deep ring from his crappy little hospital TV. In hospital, I'm offered psychiatric care. Mental health issues are actually really common with congenital heart patients. In fact, some studies show that as many as one-third of us suffer from these problems, and even it's more prevalent than humans. But thinking that I was the exception, and I'm going to be fine, I declined care. Now autumn again, a year since this entire journey began, and while my body has healed, my mind was starting to deteriorate. Thunderous clouds began to surround me. My body was possessed by feelings of trepidation. My face is numb, my shoulders are tense. I can't anticipate when it will happen. There's very little pause. Leaving the apartment to walk the dog is becoming a struggle. I can't even go to the grocery store, because going in is an act of anxiety-filled self-torture. This child, who was never wary of strangers, who told her story to anyone, this child who conversed on the streets of Paris and Singapore, is now a woman who is deeply suspicious of everyone. I find myself more and more conscious of sidewalks, terrified that people are looking at me, judging me, seeing all of my flaws and aware that I am wrongly. I know that these people aren't judging me. It doesn't work. I can't logic my way out of that. I can no longer drive a car. I can only travel in passenger seat. Earbuds in, sleep mask on, hood pulled up, blocking up the world like a zombie. They start to drive again. Winter shop? At least pretend that I'm a functioning human being. I still see the light bulb, the concrete barrier, the ease with which I can drive my car into oblivion, pick up speed, go over time, hit the wall. I pass out in the shock of the airbag. It would be so easy. But I don't believe it. Sitting in the tub, I handle the blade and contemplate the grief it will provide. She knows not to bother me when I'm in the tub. She wouldn't find me until I'm dead. I don't know that too much. It would be so easy to do this, to allow the blood to enter into my body. But instead, I drain the tub. I lie in bed and process these horrible thoughts. I grab my backpack. I start to pack things for my stay. Pill, medications, earbuds. I need to be in the hospital. Mom? I need you to take me to care of me. What? Wait, what happened? Just... I'm tired. You know, I've been having these thoughts. And... No. I should. She puts me in bed. I take her out of the camera and fall asleep. I'm a shell of who I was. The only emotions I'm capable of projecting are negative, but somehow, perhaps it's my final instinct of survival, I don't She's my niece.